And this time around, it's 170 meters to a gold medal. A gold medal for the United States, their second gold medal of these World Championships. And it just illustrates and indicates how much the Nordic division of women's and men's sport has improved across the United States in the last 2 to 3 seasons. And Keegan Randall, largely thanks to Jessica Diggins, coming home to become the freestyle skate team sprint champions of 2013. This is Oslo, this is the Holmen Kollen. Come rain, come shine, come fog, come snow, they're out there, many of them overnight around the trail. For them, this is the big race. Spinning round, wearing 26, Noah Hoffman of the United States in a black race suit there. Not to be confused with the black of Switzerland, which has got silver bits on the side.
I would like to hold my courses there are incredible. They're some of the hardest courses I've had, I've seen anywhere in the world. The skate course in particular has a climb that's almost 5 minutes long. It is like 500 feet of elevation gain. It's just an incredible climb. That'll suit really well for me. I'm really looking forward to the 50K when we go up that thing five times.
The sprint course in Sochi is hands down the hardest course that I've ever seen on the World Cup or anywhere else in the world. It's got two absolutely massive climbs in it. It's got two extremely sketchy corners that you're always just hanging right on the edge. And it's about 4 minutes long. It's definitely on the longer side, and it's at 5,000 feet. So it should be pretty interesting. It's definitely a tough man's course, and I'm looking forward to it.
Simi Hamilton on the first leg for the United States. Dietmar Nöckler for Italy.
Team in Vancouver really motivated me to strive towards Sochi because our whole team was very competitive in the sport, but we had never had an Olympic medal before, and winning three individual medals as well as a team medal was out of this world, and it gave a lot of kids hope for Sochi, gave him something to dream about.
The best part about growing up in Aspen as a kid was the amount of support that you got from this community and this extended family. I remember in our house growing up, we had this thing called the 8-inch rule, and if it snowed 8 inches or more during the night, you got to take school off for the day and go powder skiing. And you'd go up on the mountain, you know, we'd ride our bikes to the mountain and park them, and you'd go up and you'd be waiting in the gondola line, and you'd see all of your best friends and their parents there. And it was just such a cool experience to be able to appreciate the outdoors and being passionate for something like skiing and just being outside. And you know, for as long as I can remember, that's what this town and this community is about, is just living a great life with so many people around you and so many friends and so much family.